Hello, good morning student. See, now we'll see our next point, that is a neutralization reaction. See, till now you have learned about acid and bases, okay? And what are the difference in between them? And some examples also you have learned. So today we'll see what is a neutralization reaction. See, here the reaction in which an acid reacts with a base to form salt and water is called a neutralization reaction. Now see, when acid is react with base, so what we have to take some amount of acid and add some drop of base also, means react when acid react with base, it forms salt and water. And why? During this reaction, the heat is produced. Okay, so the heat is released by performing this reaction. So here I have given one example, that is HCl. HCl means what? Hydrochloric acid. So when HCl react with NaOH, now NaOH sodium hydroxide. So this HCl is acid. NaOH sodium hydroxide is a base. When this acid react with base, it forms NaCl, means sodium chloride. Okay, and water. See, sodium chloride and water. NaCl means what? Sodium chloride and NaOH sodium hydroxide. So this reaction is known as a neutralization reaction. While performing this reaction, the heat is released, heat is produced. So this is a neutralization reaction. Maybe you have understand the neutralization reaction means what. Neutralization, in short, I will tell you now again. Neutralization reaction means when acid react with base, it forms salt and water, and while this reaction, the heat is released out. This process is known as, this reaction is known as a neutralization reaction. Here one example I give you, okay? So after this lecture, you just write these all the points in your chemistry notebook. Now with practical, how the neutralization reaction occurs, that we will see. Okay, now we will perform a practically how the neutralization reaction occurs. Okay, so for that we need, see, this is a dilute HCl. Now dilute means what? You know, because already we have discussed about the dilute. So in this, water is in more amount and acid is in less amount. Okay, so this is, see here, DIL means what? Dilute HCl. So for neutralization reaction, we need this dilute HCl and this is a dilute NaOH. Now dilute NaOH means sodium hydroxide. See, I have written here acid HCl and NaOH. Okay, so this is sodium hydroxide and this one is dilute HCl. Okay, and when these HCl and sodium hydroxide, means acid and base, react with each other, they form NaCl, sodium chloride and water. Okay, so now we will perform the practical. So see, in these two beaker, this first one beaker, I have taken HCl, okay, dilute HCl. In this second beaker, I have taken NaOH. Now see what we have to do. See, take one test tube. See, this is known as a test tube. Okay, and these is known as a test tube holder. Okay, why it is used to hold this test tube? Okay, so this is test tube holder and this one is a test tube. So now what we have to do? First, take a base, means sodium hydroxide, approximately 5 ml sodium hydroxide we have to take in a test tube. Okay, see here, sodium hydroxide, and then add a 2 drops of phenolphthalein indicator. Okay, see, this is a phenolphthalein indicator. Just add, you observe it properly. Yeah? See, it turns into pink color. Why? Because this NaOH is base, and when we are adding phenolphthalein indicators in this, so it turns into pink color. Okay, now what we'll add this HCl in this, okay, drop wise, and just observe it properly. Now see the color pink. Now the neutralization process, how the reaction occurs, you just observe it. We'll add a drop wise HCl in this. See the color disappear. Okay, why? Because we added acid in this. Now here the acid and base reacting with each other. If you will hold this test tube and you will touch here, it is the little bit hot. Why? Because the heat is released out, heat is produced. Again, what we'll do, you just observe it. We'll add 2 drops of NaOH. See, when we are adding NaOH, then see, again the pink color appears. Why? Because phenolphthalein, when we added phenolphthalein indicator, it turns into pink. Okay, so see now, and if you will add again this HCl, then just observe it, just shake it, see the color disappear. Okay, this is a continue. If you will add the sodium hydroxide, again color will appear. If you will add this, then again color will disappear. So this acid and base reacting with each other now, and it produce heat, and this NaCl, sodium chloride and water, is formed. Okay, so this process is known as a neutralization reaction. So you are thinking, when you will come in the school, so that time will perform practically, means what, I will give you chance to perform this practical. Okay, so maybe you have understand about neutralization reaction. So neutralization reaction means what? Acid react with base, it forms salt. Now see, if this is in this, acid and base both are there, and they reacted with each other. So here the NaCl, sodium chloride and water, is formed. Okay, so this reaction is known as a neutralization reaction. Now common example I am giving you, see, when the acid concentration increase in our body, so we are taking a means, and that magnesium hydroxide is present in that medicine. Okay, so that medicine we have taken, why? To neutralize our body. So when we take a base, okay, so it neutralizes. These are the chemicals, these chemicals we are using in the laboratories to make different things, but in our day-to-day life, HCl is already present in our stomach. Okay, and when this percentage increase, so that time we feel a acidity, and for that we are, you means doctor suggest us to take this medicine. So that medicine, it contain base, and when medicine, so then it neutralize our body and then feel relax. Okay, so this is a neutralization process. Now at this point we will continue in next lecture. Thank you.